Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital class. In my previous lecture, I have already discussed about the affine cipher, which is one of the monoalphabetic cipher. Now, in this lecture, I am going to discuss about the polyalphabetic cipher. Let us start. First of all, what is polyalphabetic cipher? Polyalphabetic cipher is a substitution cipher in which the same letter in plain text can be replaced by the different letter in ciphertext. For example, suppose in our plain text there is a alphabet A which is present at the beginning of our plain text as well as present in the middle of our plain text. That means when we encrypt this plain text by using the polyalphabetic cipher, then the first A which is present in your beginning of the plain text is replaced by the other letter, suppose that letter is D. Then the another alphabet or another letter which is present in your middle of the plain text, that alphabet or that A is replaced by the another letter, suppose that letter is N. In this case, the same letter A which is present at the beginning of our plain text as well as present in your middle of the plain text, this same A is replaced by the different letter in your ciphertext. This is called the polyalphabetic cipher. That means the relationship between the plain text letter and the ciphertext letter is one to many. Basically, Playfair cipher and Wiesner cipher are the polyalphabetic cipher. First of all, we discuss about the Playfair cipher. The Playfair cipher is one of the substitution cipher, or you can say that it is a practical digraph cipher, which means in Playfair cipher, here the pair of letters is encrypted, but in case of other cipher, only single letter is encrypted. And this Playfair cipher was invented in the year 1854 by Charles Wheatstone, but it is named after Lord Playfair because he was prompted to use this cipher. According to them, the name is Playfair. But in case of Playfair cipher, here we use a 5x5 matrix. Now, I am going to discuss about the encryption technique of the Playfair cipher. For encryption technique in Playfair cipher, the example is, suppose key equal to monarchy and plain text is instrument. Now, the algorithm consists of two steps. First step is generate the key square matrix, which is a 5x5 matrix. And the second step is follow the encryption rule. First, I am going to discuss about the generation of key square matrix. Now, look at here. Here, the initial alphabet in the key square matrix are the unique alphabet of the key in the order in which they are appear. That means, in our example, the key is monarchy. And here, the first alphabet is M, then O, then N, then A, then R, then C, then H, then Y. That means, the rule says that when we create our 5x5 key square matrix, first of all, we fill up the matrix by using the alphabet of our key. That means the first cell of our matrix contains the first alphabet of our key, that is M. Then the next cell contains the next alphabet of our key, that is O. In this way, we fill up our matrix cell from left to right by using the alphabet of our key. Then next, the other cell will be filled up by the remaining alphabet of our alphabet set. For example, here, when you fill up this matrix by using the keyword monarchy, after that this cell is filled by which letter? First of all, you have to check the alphabet set letter, that is from A to Z. First of all, for filling this cell, you first take the alphabet A, but the alphabet A is also present in this cell. That means if the alphabet which you take to fill up this cell, if this alphabet is present in your keyword, then you cannot take this alphabet again. Then you take the next alphabet, that is B. Now you check this alphabet B is present in this cell or not. If this alphabet B is not present in these cells, then you can fill up. That means in your keyword, there is no alphabet B. For this reason, B is filled here. Now, the next cell is filled by the letter, suppose C, but C is also present in this cell. That means we cannot fill this cell by C. Then the next letter is D. Again, you check this D letter is present in your keyword or not. If this letter is not present, then you can fill up this cell by using the letter D. In this way, you can fill all these letters in our matrix, which are not present in our keyword. But this is a 5x5 matrix. That means it has 25 number of cells. But our alphabet set has 26 number of alphabet. For this reason, the I and J alphabet are placed in same cell. Now, this is our 5x5 matrix, which is created by using the keyword, that is monarchy. Then next, here this is the steps 2 for the algorithm. The steps 2 says that it follows the encryption rule. And the first encryption rule is that, first of all, you split the plain text into a pair of alphabet. That means whatever the text given in your plain text, first of all, you pair all these alphabets. If your plain text contains odd number of alphabet, then you can add a letter, that is Z, at the end of your plain text, so that you can easily pair your plain text. So the next rule is that when you pair your plain text, if one of the pair contain the same letter, then in this case, these same letters are replaced by a letter, that is the letter Z. For example, this is our plain text, that is instruments. Here, the plain text contains odd number of alphabets. For this reason, when we are pairing these plain text, we add this letter Z at the end of our plain text, so that we can easily pair our plain text. And the second example is that here plain text is balloon. And when we pair this plain text, the second pair contains the letter LL. That means this pair contains the same letter. Here, you can use the letter Z to separate these letters. That means our pair is BA, LZ, LO, then ON. In this way, you can first pair your plain text, then you follow the encryption rule. Here, the first rule says that if both the letter of your pair present in the same column, then you can take the letter below of your pair letter. That means here, look at the example. In your example, the plain text pair contains the letter M, E. And now you find out which cell this M and E are present. Now, look at this matrix. In this matrix, this cell contains M and this cell contains E. That means these two letters are present in one column. When you encrypt these two letters, according to the rule, for M, you take the letter C, which is below of this letter. And for E, you can take the letter L. That means for the M, E, the ciphertext is CL. Here, first of all, you check your plain text pair. If these pair of letters are present in the same column, then you can take the letter below of this pair letter. Then the next rule. Here, the next rule says that if both the letters are in the same row, take the letter to the right of each. That means, suppose take an example. In your example, the plain text pair contains ST. Now, you look where these two letters are present in your matrix. Now, this is the S and this is the T. That means when you encrypt this S and T, first of all you check whether these two letters are present in one column or one row. Here these two letters are present in one row. That means when you want to encrypt, you according to the rule, the S is encrypted by the T and the T is encrypted by the letter L. That means if the letter is the last cell, then you back to the beginning of this row. That means here T is replaced by the letter A and S is replaced by the letter T. Now for the pair ST, the encrypted text is TL. Now the next rule. Here this rule says that if both the first rules are not satisfied, that means if the pair of letters are not present in the same column or same row, then you can make a rectangle by using this pair of letter. Now look at the example. This is our example. Here in our example, the pair is NT. Now look at the matrix. In our matrix, here is the N and here is the T. Now these N and T are not present in single column or single row. That means according to the rule, first of all we can create a rectangle by using this N and T, and this is the rectangle which is created by using the letter N and T. After creating the rectangle, then you take the opposite corner of the letter. That means for N you can take the letter R and for T you can take the letter Q. Now for the letter NT, the encrypted text is RQ. Now this shows the example of a Playfair cipher where the plain text is instruments and the key is monarchy. When the plain text is instrument, first of all you have to pair this plain text. Here the pair of the plain text, and the first pair contains the alphabet I and N. First of all you check whether these two letters are present in one column or one row. Here in this figure N is present here and L is present here, and these two letters are not present in single column or single row. That means here we can apply our rule 3, which says that you first create a rectangle by using these letters, that is N and T, and this is the rectangle. After creating rectangle, then you can replace by using the opposite corner letter. That means here N is replaced by the letter A and I is replaced by the letter G. Now the next pair contains the letter ST. Here you check whether these letters are present in one column or not. Now in our matrix, this is the S and this is the T. Now these two letters are present in single row. That means here we can apply the rule 2. The rule 2 says that the letters are replaced by their right letter. That means here S is replaced by the letter T and T is replaced by the letter L. The next pair contains RU. Here the letter R is present and here the letter U is present, and these two letters are not in one column or one row. That means here we apply the rule 3. We can create a matrix by using these two letters, and this is the matrix. By using this letter we create the rectangle. After creating the rectangle, we can replace this letter by their opposite corner letter. That means your R is replaced by M and U is replaced by Z. Now the next pair is ME. Here in our matrix, M is present here and E is present here, and both the letter are present in one column. That means we can use the rule 1. Here the M is replaced by C and E is replaced by L. Now the next pair is NT. Here N is present and here T is present, and these two letters are not in same row or same column. That means here we apply the rule 3, which is to make a rectangle by using this letter, and the rectangle is this one. Here we replace the N by R and T by Q. And the last pair contains SZ. Now look at our matrix. In our matrix, this is S and this is Z, and these two letters are not in same column or same row. That means here we create a rectangle by using these two letters, and the rectangle is this one, and this S is replaced by T and this Z is replaced by X. Now, for our plain text instrument, the ciphertext is GATLMZCLRQ and TX. This is the plain text encryption rules or plain text encryption algorithm. Next, decryption process of Playfair cipher. Decryption process is nothing but the reverse of the encryption process. Here, we use the same 5 square 5 cross 5 matrix, and we form this 5 cross 5 matrix by using the keyword alphabet and the remaining alphabet of our alphabet set. After that, we use the decryption rules. For example, here the key is monarchy and the ciphertext is GATLMZCLRQ and TX. Now, next is the Playfair cipher decryption algorithm. The Playfair cipher decryption algorithm contains two steps, and the first step is very similar to the encryption first step. That means in the first step, the key square matrix is generated, which is a 5 cross 5 matrix, and the process is very similar to the encryption step 1 algorithm. That means here we create our 5 cross 5 key square matrix by using the alphabet of our keyword. Then we fill the remaining cell of our matrix by using the remaining alphabet of our alphabet set. After that, we follow the decryption rule. This is the second step of our decryption algorithm. But here you remember that in our encryption, when you use the encryption algorithm, the first rule is that first we pair the plain text. And if the plain text contains odd number of alphabets, then we add a letter Z at the end of our plain text to make the pair. But in case of our ciphertext, there is always even number of alphabets in our ciphertext. Now, this is the example how we can create a 5 cross 5 key square matrix, which is very similar to our encryption process. In this matrix, first we fill up the cell by using our keyword, and here the keyword is monarchy. That means here we first fill the keyword monarchy in our matrix, then we follow the remaining alphabet of our alphabet set. Then next is the step 2. In the step 2, the decryption algorithm says that first of all we split our ciphertext into pair of two letters, but our ciphertext always contain the even number of letters or even number of characters. That means your ciphertext is GATLMZCLRQTX. After pairing, the ciphertext contains the pair GATLMZCLRQTX. Next, rules for decryption. The first rule says that if both the letters are in the same column, take the letter above each one and going back to the button at the top. That means if our ciphertext pair contain the letter which are present in same column. For example, take this pair of our ciphertext, that is CL. Now look at here, this is the C and this is the L. Now these two letters are present in same column. That means here we replace the letter C by the letter M and the letter L by the letter E. But in case our encryption, always we replace the letter below to it. But the decryption is the reverse one. For this reason, here we replace the letter present above it. That means here C is replaced by M and L is replaced by E. Next is the second rule. The second rule says that if both the letters are in the same row, take the letters to the left of the each one. That means in our example, the letter is TL, which is our ciphertext pair. Now, in this figure, this is T and this is L. Here, this T and L both are present in the same row. That means here we can replace this letter T and L with the letter which is present at the left. That means here T is replaced by S and L is replaced by T. The next one, this is the third rule of decryption. The third rule says that if both the first rules are not true, that means if the pair contains the letter which are not present in the same column or same row, then we create a rectangle by using the letter and take the letter which are present opposite to the letter. That means, for example, here our pair is RQ. Now, R is here and Q is here, and these two letters are not present in the same row or same column. That means here we create a rectangle, and this is the rectangle created by R and Q. After creating the rectangle, we can replace the letter by their opposite corner letter. That means here R is replaced by N and Q is replaced by T. For this reason, for RQ, the decrypted text is NT. Now, this example shows the decryption of the ciphertext, that is GATLMZCLRQTX, by using the decryption algorithm of Playfair Cipher, which I have already discussed. Here, the GA is replaced by IN and TL is replaced by ST and MZ is replaced by RU and CL is replaced by ME and RQ is replaced by NT and TX is replaced by SZ. That means for our ciphertext GATLMZCLRQTX, our decrypted text or plain text is instruments Z, because here Z is the letter which is added to make this plain text into E. Here this is your plain text. Next one is the Wiesner cipher. It is also one of the polyalphabetic cipher. In this cipher, the key stream is generated by using a different strategy. That means here key stream is a string, but this key stream is repeated to encrypt our plain text. Now look at the example. Suppose our plain text is P, that means here each alphabet is P1, P2, P3 and ciphertext is C, that means here each alphabet is C1, C2 and C3. And our encryption algorithm is that CI equal to PI plus KI mod 26. That means here we take the one alphabet of our plain text, then add with your one alphabet of our key stream, then find out the mod 26. This is the encryption algorithm. Here the decryption algorithm PI equal to CI minus KI. That means here we subtract the key from our ciphertext to getting the plain text. Now take one example. In our example, this is the plain text hello and this is the key hi. First of all, when you want to encrypt this plain text by using the Wiesner cipher, then first of all you write the plain text in this way. That is, in your plain text, the first alphabet is H, then E, then L, L, O. Then next you write the numeric equivalent of these alphabets. This is the numeric equivalent of these alphabets. After that, you write the key alphabet. When you write the key alphabet, this is our key is HI, but here our key is ended. That means for other alphabet of our plain text, what is our key? Here for this reason, you have to repeat your key. That means first you write HI, after that you also write the H, then I, then H. That means when you use the Wiesner cipher for encryption, in this case our initial key is repeated the length of our plain text. Here the first alphabet of our plain text is H and the alphabet of our key is H. After that, what you can do? You can find the numeric equivalent of our key. Here, this is the numeric equivalent of our key. After that, You use the encryption algorithm to encrypt this plain text by using this key. Here, this is the encryption of our plain text alphabet. Here, the first alphabet of our plain text is H, and the first alphabet of our key is H, and the numeric value is 77. That means when you apply our encryption algorithm, that is 7 plus 7 mod 26, that is equal to 14. In this way, you use the encryption algorithm for all the alphabet of our plain text. After that, you find out the alphabet equivalent of these ciphertext values. This is the alphabetic equivalent of these values. That means for 14 the alphabet is O, and for 12 the alphabet is M, and for 18 the alphabet is S, and for 19 the alphabet is T, and for 20 the alphabet is B. That means for our plain text hello, the ciphertext is O, M, S, T, B. This is the technique of encryption by using the Wiesner cipher. Next is the decryption. Here for decryption the ciphertext is O, M, S, T, B, and the key is same, that is high. Now when you want to decrypt this ciphertext by using the Wiesner cipher, first of all you have to write the ciphertext in this way. Then next you find out the numeric equivalent of the alphabet of our ciphertext. This is here the numeric equivalent of O is 14, and the numeric equivalent of M is 12, and S is 18, T is 19, and B is 21. After that you write the key. Here the key is high, but we repeat this key to the length of our ciphertext. Then you find out the numeric equivalent of your key. This is the numeric equivalent of our key. After that you use the decryption algorithm to find out the plain text. Now this is the decryption algorithm which is used for every alphabet of our ciphertext. Here the first alphabet of our ciphertext is O, and which numeric value is 14. For this reason here 14 minus 7, that is the key value, and this is the key value 7. That means 14 minus 7 mod 26 equal to 7. In this way you can apply the decryption algorithm for all the alphabet of our ciphertext. After applying the decryption algorithm, these are the values of the plain text. Then next you convert these values into the alphabet value. Now this is the corresponding alphabet for this numeric value. Here for 7 the alphabet is H, and for 4 the alphabet is E, and for 11 the alphabet is L, and here also for 11 the alphabet is L, and here also for 14 the alphabet is O. That means here for the ciphertext O, M, S, T, V, our plain text is hello, H, E, L, L, O, and this is the decryption process of Wiesner cipher. Next is the Hill cipher. In Hill cipher, it uses the linear algebra. That means in Hill cipher, the plain text is converted into the vector form, and it is multiplied with a key which is in the invertible matrix form. That means for encryption, we use the plain text which is multiplied with the key matrix and gives the ciphertext, and for decryption, here we multiply the ciphertext vector with the multiplicative inverse of the key matrix and it gives the plain text. Now look at the example. Here for encryption our message or plain text is ACTE, ACT, and here the N value is 3. That means here it contains the 3 alphabets. Now here the key is G, Y, B, N, Q, K, U, R, P, which can be written as the N cross N matrix, because here our plain text is ACT which N value is N equal to 3. That means when we create the key, that must be N cross N matrix, and this is the key. Then the message ACT is written as a vector form, that is 0 to 9, because here ये द न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज जीरो, दैट मीन्स हियर वी पुट जीरो. देन द न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू ऑफ सी इज टू, दैट मीन्स हियर वी पुट सी. देन द न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू ऑफ टी इज 19. इन दिस वे यू कैन मेक द वेक्टर फॉर द प्लेन टेक्स्ट. आफ्टर क्रिएटिंग द वेक्टर एंड द की मैट्रिक्स, देन यू अप्लाई द एनक्रिप्शन एल्गोरिथम. हियर the encryption algorithm is that the key value is multiplied with our plain text vector. This is the key value and this is the plain text vector. After performing the multiplication, this is the result. When this result is come out, then you find out the mod 26. After find out the mod 26, this is the result, or this is the ciphertext vector. Now here for 15 the letter is P, and for 14 the letter is O, and for 7 the letter is H. That means for our plain text ACTE, our ciphertext is POH. Next, decryption. The decryption is the reverse process of encryption. First of all, when you want to decrypt our message by using the Hill cipher, here you calculate the inverse matrix of our key, and this is our original matrix and this is the inverse of our key matrix. After find out the inverse of the matrix, then you apply the decryption algorithm. Here this is the rule how you can find out the inverse of a matrix. Now here this is the matrix, key matrix inverse, and this is our ciphertext. When you multiply these two matrix, after that you get another matrix which is our plain text matrix. But in this case the plain text is 0 to 19, because this matrix is a matrix which is not calculated by using the mod 26. When you get this type of result, we can apply the mod 26, or we can calculate the mod 26 of this matrix, then whatever we get, that is our original matrix, or that is our plain text matrix. Here our plain text matrix contains 0 to 19. 0 is the A, then 2 is the value of C, and 19 is the value of T, which is our plain text. I hope you get some idea about polyalphabetic cipher. And within the polyalphabetic cipher, you get some idea about the Playfair cipher and Wiesner cipher and also the Hill cipher. If you have any doubt regarding this lecture, then you can ask me through comment. We will discuss about the doubt. Thank you for watching.